Side. Hi everyone, thanks for joining me. I'm Juliana with the Zakim Center and this is Yoga Flow. So this class was created for people that have been practicing yoga for a little bit, and if you feel like you wanted to add a little bit more, this was kind of like an idea of approaching it in a different flow so you have a little bit more movement, a little bit more range of motion. Again, if you feel any form of way it's too much for you today, feel free to change it. This is the most important thing in yoga. It's not about a pose or perfect or anything. It's just how you feel into it, feeling comfortable, feeling connected with your body. So really honoring your body where it is today. So we're going to get started. We're going to move to the mat. And from here, just kind of like lying on your back. We're going to use those two blocks. We're going to use also a strap and a blanket if you have one as well. Going to get started here. All right. So as you come to your mat, if you can find a support for your shoulder blades, bring your shoulder blades to it. And then the head is going to be on that block right behind. So when you lay back, make sure you adjust the one for your shoulder blades first. And then stretching the back of your skull to let your head go back. And if the block is not in place, then you have your hands free to adjust that block. Let your arms splay out to the side. And perhaps today, having the feet a little wider than the knees, slightly knocking. And just allowing your body to start to soften and release. If it's comfortable for you, even closing your eyes. And by closing the eyes, you start to draw that awareness in. It's one of the eight limbs of yoga, pratyahara. You start to feel your body releasing here into the mat, into the block. And to make this connection even deeper, we're going to take three cleansing breaths. So inhaling through the nose and a big sigh through the mouth. Let it go. Once again, inhaling through the nose. And a big sigh. Letting go of tension and stress. Take one more deep breath in. And sigh it out. Letting go of your baggage. Allowing your body to settle. Just feeling the support beneath you so you can let go. Support beneath the skull so you can soften the muscles in your face even more. The corners of the eyes, the cheeks, the jaw. Releasing down to the shoulders, the backs of your elbows and hands are supported so you can let go all the way to your fingertips. Noticing the shoulder blades supported so you can soften. And the heart, letting go of that emotional stress. And allow the belly to feel soft and the hips to feel heavy. The heaviness and connection with the earth brings a sense of well-being, of safety, of belonging. And you can continue to release through your knees, your ankles and toes. This is your safe place so you can let go completely. Now that the body is still, I'm going to focus a little bit more on the breath. And today we're going to take a pranayama breath control exercise. Nadi Shodhana. So that means we're going to balance the channels of the body, the right and the left, the masculine, the moon, the sun, and then balancing with the left, which is the moon, the feminine. And we're just going to start to take it into taking your peace finger and your ring finger, or your peace finger and your index finger onto your forehead. And then allowing your thumb and your ring finger just to rest along the nose. I'm just going to take a normal inhale and a normal exhale. And then after that, I'm going to guide you to closing one nostril and breathing into one, and then closing it and then breathing out through the other. And we're going to continue to do that. So if that feels too much for you, just continue to breathe normally. Otherwise, when you feel ready, finger, index finger and middle finger on your forehead, your third eye, and take a normal breath in and a normal breath out. Close the right, inhale left. Close left, exhale right. Inhale right. Close right, exhale left. Inhale left. Close left, exhale right. Inhale right. Close right, exhale left. Inhale left. Close left, exhale right. Inhale right. Close right, exhale left. Release your arms. And just feeling how the breath probably is a little bit more balanced. And also how the mind is quieter than when you're starting. So sometimes we use the breath awareness as a type of mindfulness meditation to help to calm the mind. And today we did a pranayama breath control exercise to help to calm the mind. And that's what we're looking for, that little bit of pause, the thoughts, so you can find a little bit more quiet and peace in the here and now. And this breath work that we did today helps to balance not only calming the mind, but also balancing the energy in the body, the right and the left, the masculine and the feminine, the sun and the moon. Feeling centered and present. With your next inhale, bring your hands together into Anjali Mudra prayer pose. And once again, letting the thumbs rest on the forehead. As you feel the pressure of your thumbs on your third eye, breathe in kind thoughts and positive energy. Let that fill you up. As you exhale slowly, letting your hands slide to your heart center, one over the other, over your heart. And breathing into your chest, the heart center. Breathe in the gratitude of being here today. Taking time from your busy schedule to take care of yourself. And letting your intention and gratitude settle in. Start to notice the warmth beneath your hands. The area of your body. I'm just going to focus a little bit more today. Heart opening, throat. Chest opening. And from here, start to tap right over there behind that chest bone, the sternum, is your thymus gland, which helps for your immune system, just giving it a little bit more of a boost. And start to take your hands a little bit more to the collarbones, right under to your shoulder blades. Not to the shoulder, but the tips of your shoulders, I should say, and from the bringing from the heart center and then over to closer to the shoulders. And from here, just giving it a little gentle massage, finding some movement from the shoulders to the heart. Then you're going to cross your hands under your armpits and just give it a little tap. Again, this is another area. There's a lot of lymph nodes that helps with your immune system, giving it a little bit more of a boost. And with your next inhale, start to feel your arms reaching up, lifting up from your feet. And as you exhale, start to reach back. Keep your arms along the side of the body, like a snow angel reaching down to your feet, and start to circle your arms forward and up. And as you exhale, start to reach back, soften to your elbows, and sweep them again. Take one more inhaling, going at your own range, which means you don't have to let them touch the floor. Wherever you are, it's just fine. Engage the core as you exhale, open it out to the side. Let the backs of your hands rest here. And just feeling your chest wide open. Inhale into your heart. As you exhale, you're going to start to close your elbows parallel to each other. Inhale, allow it to open. Feeling the broadening of the heart. Exhale, you close. Last time through. Inhale, open. And a big exhale, and you close. This time, lock your fingers. Take your hands behind the head, and perhaps you can take that block out of the way. And just allowing the head perhaps to drop a little further back, letting the elbows reach up to the sky. You start to get a little bit more opening into the heart center. Also getting a little bit more into the throat as it drops back slightly. Breathe into your heart, firm into your feet. And as you exhale, pull belly in, elbows come up. And then relax it back down. And with your next exhale, perhaps you take opposite elbow to knee and then bring it back down. Again, this is just to engage the core. And with your next exhale, maybe take it up and down. Exhale, twisting and down. And last one and down. Now from here, slowly take your time. And start to move your body and just start to scooch it a little bit side to side, massaging your shoulder blades to the back. And allow yourself to very gently roll to one side, enough that you can take your blocks out of the way. If you need a blanket under your head, you can put a blanket under your head and just give your knees a hug and a gentle rock. As you start to roll it here from one side and then perhaps the other. And then allowing your knees to slowly drop over to the right. Let your gaze go over to the left, and maybe your left arm starts to reach back. You start to find a little bit more opening through the side body, the armpit. You're going to roll yourself a little bit more over to the right. The left arm is going to windmill up and over like you're going to brush the floor with your hands. And you're just going to stop it when it's right over your head. And if you feel like you need a block under that hand, you can put a block there. Start to breathe into the side body. Start to open into the armpits and the shoulders. And with your next exhale, let the hands come one on top of the other. And you're going to brush your fingers onto your arm, giving it that little gentle massage. And one foot and then the other comes to the floor. And you start to winch or wipe your knees a little side to side. And then slowly let your knees stack to the other side and drop. And you can hold your knees here with your hands or put a blanket or something between. And then perhaps you let your right arm reach slightly back. Notice the breath into the right side, the kidney, the armpit. Let the head soften if you need to move it a little. And with your next exhale, slowly, I'm gonna turn my back to you for a couple of breaths. You're gonna start to slide that right arm up and over your head like a dial on a clock. And you just hang in there and just notice the breath into the side ribs and to the back. Feel that rib cage breathing and that expansion of those side ribs and back muscles, the extension through the armpit. And if you need to soften your elbow on this one, you can. Take one more breath in. And with your next exhale, slowly let that arm, one come on top of the other. And then the right foot and then the left comes up and you brush your left arm with your right. And you come back to the center, you give your knees a little bit of a hug and a rock. Circle your knees in one direction, massaging your lower back. And then circle your knees the other way. Any form of way here that works for you. Allow your feet to come down to the earth and perhaps you take one of your blocks and put it between your knees. Try to make sure that your heels are not too far away. And if you feel that you want anything more, you can hold onto the edges of your sticky mat and pull your sticky mat apart as you start to scoop your tail and feel the knees reaching forward. And as you exhale, release. Now I'm going to add a little bit of moving bridge, adding one arm at a time. Maybe you reach one arm back. And again, if this feels too much, keep that arm parallel. And as you exhale, you bring it back down. Engage the core and lift. Inhaling. And exhale, bring it back down. And then from here, just allowing your knees to come into your chest once again. And allowing the feet to come back down. This time when you come into your bridge, dig your elbows into the floor and start to feel a little bit more opening of your shoulders. Slide those shoulder blades down the back. And holding it here, opening the heart, or holding into the edges of the sticky mat and pulling that sticky mat apart. Or even clasping the hands under if that works for you. As you exhale, slowly release, let the arms slide, let the hips come back down, and you take that block out of the way. And start to locate where your strap is and just perhaps start to take it over your right foot, and bending and extending that leg. You can find a little bit more opening of the knees, of the hamstrings, hold it up there, press to the foot. And start to feel that you can push your thigh back and you resist here. With your next exhale, bend that knee, bring it in. And now you start to move that knee in and out into a half happy baby. Start to soften the belly, let the leg open. Massaging your internal organs. This is a really nice way to release tension in the back. You're gonna let your right leg open to the side. Maybe you leave it there and just finding some support under that leg. You can come to the blade of the left foot if you like to have a little bit more counterbalance for the hips. And then taking that leg up and then slowly switching the hand as you cross. Press to the heel, turn your toes slightly more to the left, like slightly pigeon toe, and your thumb comes to the crease of your hips for a little bit more release. With your next exhale, soften and drop that ankle over to the thigh for your figure four. Let your right knee move away, staying here, or taking it deeper by picking up your left foot, maybe bringing the hands behind the thigh. Just let that left leg just kind of hang, maybe rolling the ankle. Finding what works here for you. If you need to use your elbow to push your right thigh away as you bring your left knee in, just to deepen that stretch, or if you need to have that foot a little further. Wherever you are, you're going to release it, and we're going to slide that right heel forward. And just hold it there, take that left knee back in. And then quick twist over to the right. Open up to the left once again. Let that arm come all the way up and over. Start to loosen up the arms like a windmill, bring the knees back in. Give yourselves a little bit of a hug and a rock. This time the right foot stays on the floor, the left knee stays in. You can hold behind here and start to kick that leg up and down. Maybe pointing and flexing the toe and rolling the ankle. And to the other side, we're gonna take that strap over the foot. Find a little bit more pressing of the heel. The resisting of the thigh back. With your next exhale, soften, let that knee come in to your shoulder. Holding both ends of the strap, bending the knee, half happy baby, let that sway. To help to release the back, helping massaging your internal organs. And we're gonna open into the groin and let that left leg open out to the side. Start to feel your inner leg. You can support it any form of way if it preferred like that, or even the blade of the foot to the side to counterbalance to keep the hips level. From the right foot, take that left leg up and then switch the hands, press with the heel, slightly pigeon toe. And you can take your left thumb to the crease of your left hip to roll it out, feeling a little bit more IT band work. And with your next exhale, soften and release. Perhaps you take the strap out. Perhaps you use the strap between the legs under the right thigh to bring that foot in. Wherever here works for you. You're just playing with this. Maybe you relax that leg, maybe you roll the ankle, even rock the body. You're just noticing how this feels. And with your next exhale, slowly drop the right foot And slide your left heel all the way to the front. Then let the right knee come in and guide it over to the left as you open your right arm up to the side. Notice the side body stretch once again. And as you start to take that arm up and over, noticing the sensations through the side body, the armpit, the shoulders. And when your knee, hand comes to the knees, both knees come back in and you find your roll. We're gonna turn this around. We're gonna face the mat. So when you feel ready, come back down. And then start to let your elbows go slightly ahead of you. Relax your head. Now feel that your elbows can push in, pull in, and then start to feel that your collarbones, your chest starts to spread open. Your toes are reaching back like magnets. Shoulders are moving away from the ears, and then relax your head. So from your sphinx, we're gonna slowly drop it down and let the fingertips come along the side of the mat. Press into your palms and roll your shoulders back. Now again, think about crown of the head reaching forward like a flashlight, pointing straight forward, and your toes reaching back, pressing into the tops of the mat so that you feel that nice long engagement of the spine, the upper back muscles is what's lifting you up here. And then soften and release. If you need to make a little pile with your hands for crocodile, you can, and just relax it out. Let's try that once again, and maybe slide those hands back, press into the palms, roll the shoulders up and away from your ears. Toes are reaching back. Some of you might even take your hands and think about you're holding a block here between your hands, and maybe that will lift you a little bit more. Don't think about high, but think about long, and then slowly release. So that was a modified locust. Let your elbows come back again, and just to relax the neck and the shoulders, let it soften here. You can always come back to your sphinx if you don't like the locust or modified locust, or even the low cobra. We're gonna take our hands closer to our body into that low cobra and roll the shoulders up and back, and now firm into your hands and push to come up to your tabletop. If you like, take the blanket under your knees for extra padding. And then from this, we're gonna slowly start to play a little bit more with our cats and calves, letting the head soften, the hips sway. And maybe even taking your hands over to the right. You can push into that right hand and feel the left arm reaching more so you can get deeper into the side body. And then slowly take it back to the other side. Push with the left and reach with the right, noticing the sensation with the head softened here, side body is opening. And perhaps you even start to take it even deeper, and you can hold the edges of your sticky mat and pull it away from you and apart. Let your tailbone stick up to the sky and you're coming into your puppy pose. Now, again, if this feels too much for you, soften, you can drop your elbows down, that's okay. Forehead can come maybe down to the floor. And with your next exhale, soften and then allow your sit bones to come back to your heels. Maybe you find your child's pose. If you prefer to put a block or something under your head, you can. Press into your hands and feel like they're gonna drag and help you to come back up into your tabletop. Find the core stability as we start to slide the right toes back and start to pump that heel. Now again, engage your core so you're not kind of dumping into the back, but you're pulling that navel in. And then reach your left fingertips forward, left thumb goes up. Like you're gonna shake somebody's hand. When you feel ready, pick up your right leg. Exhale, elbows and knees might come together. Inhale, you might find a little bit of reach. And as you exhale, can you take your elbow to the side, knee to the side? Drop the hand, extend the leg, move the hips. Feeling that inner leg stretch. We're gonna thread the needle and open the back of the shoulders, the back now. Stay on your right hand and let your left arm reach up for your elbow. And as you exhale, thread the needle, slide it under. And as you drop that hand, maybe the fingertips come in front of your face and push it, and you revolve that shoulder even more. You can even take the hand behind the back if that works better for you. There's so many ways you can do this. With your next exhale, you're going to very gently support the hand, and you're going to let your right foot move all the way to the front. Perhaps you have blocks here for your hands, if you like, and you can have the hands on the blocks and let your hips drop and the chest lifts. And as you exhale, pressing into that heel and pushing the hips back. So you can continue here, blocks or no blocks. Next time you come forward, maybe allow your arms to sweep all the way up. You're coming into your low lunge. As you exhale, pull the tips of your shoulder blades together. Start to find a little bit more opening in your heart. Maybe you clasp your hands behind you. And you roll your shoulders back one at a time. Start to find a little bit more lifting of the sternum of the heart. Remember that area that we were tapping before. And as we exhale, we're going to bow. And as you bow, release your left hand down, take your right arm up and backstroke that arm. Nice. Now from this, we're gonna move back with that foot. As we inhale, you open forward. And as we exhale, we round it back. I'm gonna take the same thing on the other side. So you start to slide your left foot back. You start to pump, getting the toes, the ankles. Stay firm on that hand, engage your core, and start to take your right fingertips forward. Again, like you're going to shake somebody's hand, then engage the core and lift up. Exhale, elbows and knees. Inhale, maybe reach. Exhale, can you take it to the side and knee to the side? Start to find that option. Maybe you stay there on the side and just extend that leg out. Move your hips a little bit back and forth. Start to notice your inner leg. I'm going to stay with the left hand on the floor, and the right arm or elbow, depending how you feel on this side, goes up. And as you exhale, you thread the needle, slide it on. Now with that sliding, tip the fingers open, maybe staying here, reaching the arm up, or even wrapping it behind the back. And that might give you a little bit more rotation of the shoulder, deepening that twist. As you exhale, release, let the hand come down to the earth. Slide your fingertips from under, and the foot is going to step all the way to the front, just like you did before. Maybe you have blocks here for your hands, and let your chest open. And as you exhale, you press into your heel and you push your hips back. And it's your choice. You can move the block along the side of the leg, finding a little bit more lift. Try not to let the front knee pass the toes. That's the only kind of like risky. You put too much pressure on your knee. The only reason why we avoid it. As you exhale, you pull, chest lifting. Clasp your hands, and once again, roll your shoulders back. See if you can find a little bit more opening of the heart. And as you exhale, you start to soften forward. Release the right hand, left arm goes up, and you backstroke that arm, really helping to open into the heart. And from here, slowly step that foot back. From this, take your hands up to the sky, kneeling salutation. And as you exhale, bring your hands to your heart. Let's take those two blocks out to the front, and we're gonna step one foot, take the blocks out, and then the other forward. Find the support that you need, wait a little bit more into the heels, and then allow your arms to come all the way up. And as you find yourself up, bring your hands to your heart. Connect with your feet. And finding that stability in the body. So we're kind of, from the front of the mat, we're going to move to the center of the mat. So we're going to change this today into a little bit more of a moon salutation. And I kind of like to keep those blocks there just in case if you need it. You can even move them a little further out if you need. As you press into your feet, inhale, let your arms go up, reach up. And as you hold onto your right wrist, lean over to the left, creating your crescent moon. Inhale back to the center. And exhale, soften. Find a hold of the other wrist. Inhale up. Press into the feet and exhale. Lean, open the heart maybe a little bit more. Inhale, come back to the center and exhale, release it all the way down. From here, we're gonna step our feet a little wider. Turning the toes slightly out, inhale, take your arms up. Exhale, open into that star shape. Find the reach to the fingertips. And with your next exhale, you're gonna bend your knees. So your knees and your toes are kind of like, I'm just taking those blocks in the same direction. You're finding your goddess pose. Imagine that the back is nice and long, like supported against the wall. Inhale here. And as you exhale, you tip it over to one side. Inhale, center. And as you exhale, you tip it to the other. Inhale, center. Exhale, you press, you come back to the center. Now you're gonna turn your right toe slightly forward, left toes facing straight forward. This is when you're gonna take that block and you're gonna bring it to the side. So inhale, open it up. So you're coming into your Trikonasana triangle. Start to hinge from your hips and let that hand support on your thighs. Some of you might take it further down to your shin or to your block. The other hand comes to your hips, and as you inhale, open your shoulder back. Soften into that front knee as much as you need. So it's almost like a between an extended side angle and a triangle, right? So you're not locking in the knees. If you feel comfortable taking that arm up, you can take the arm up, inhale. And as you exhale, slowly lower it down. You're gonna take the other block with you, just bring it forward. And turning now both toes to face forward, and your feet are hip width distance apart. As you inhale, find a little bit of length, and again, try not to lock into the front knee. You're coming into your version of pyramid pose. As you exhale, maybe even taking those blocks slightly ahead so you feel length of the spine and the hands are supported. Take one more breath here. And with your next exhale, you're gonna bend that front knee a lot and just slide the back knee down to the earth. As you inhale, you come into your low lunge. Lift up, Anjaliasana, crescent lunge. And as you exhale, you slowly lower it down. Now we're gonna take that right hand to the floor and let the left arm open back, and maybe you tuck the back toes and extend. And as you exhale, slowly bring it down. This is something similar to what we did. Take your blocks or your hands and walk it over to the other side. So the back heel drops, and it's gonna look like a little snake move. You're gonna press into one leg, walk your blocks to the other side. And from here, you're gonna turn your toes, and we're gonna do the same thing on the other side. So it's a little turning and moving, drop the knee. You're creating this full circle, this full moon. Inhaling, lifting. And as you exhale, you slowly fold. Now when you fold, take those blocks with you, tuck the back toes. And again, you're coming up into that little bit of a pyramid pose. So the arms can go a little bit more forward and you lengthen the spine, or they can just drop here close to you. The knee is soft, so try not to lock the knee. And feel that you can square your hips and your chest slightly forward. Take one more breath here. And with your next exhale, slowly soften. You're gonna drop the back heel in an angle. The front leg stays the same way, just maybe moving the blocks a little closer to you if you need. One hand can come to the hip, and you start to revolve the shoulder, the chest back. You might stay here or even taking that arm up to the side. Soften into that front knee just a little bit and use that hand to bring you up. You're gonna turn your toes once again and bring your hands to your hips. Roll your shoulders, heel toe your feet. So now your heels are in, your toes are out, and you come back into your goddess pose. Inhale into your heart. And as you exhale, tip it to one side. Inhale, center. And exhale, tip it to the other side. And then from here, slowly press into your feet. Bring your hands to your heart. And as you exhale, heel to your feet closer once again. Allow the arms to reach up, lift up. Hold on to the left wrist and take a side bend, crescent moon. If you want to take it even deeper, start to shift the weight more to that left foot. And maybe that right foot will just slightly move lighter. firm, come back in and release. Roll your shoulders back and give it a try on the other side. So you're finding your balance, exploring it here, holding onto the wrist and start to shift the weight. Press into that big toe mound and maybe you start to get light onto your left toes. And just play with that, see if maybe the heart will open. You're finding your balance in any formal way that works for you. Come back to the center. And as you exhale, start to cactus your arms open and then release it all the way down. Roll your shoulders back. Nicely done. So we're gonna take that strap just for one more breath here. You're gonna take it up like if you're doing your goddess. Soften into your knees and pull the elbows slightly back. There's a tendency of dropping it out. So drop the tail, knit the ribs in and pull it. Start to feel that sensation. Soften into your knees and perhaps you take it to one side. Come back to the center and then pull a little bit more onto the other side. And come back to the center. And as you exhale, release it out, roll the shoulders back. And taking the strap behind you now, have the fingers facing forward, the thumbs out. Your elbows are gonna be bent and you're gonna roll the shoulders back. Pull the strap apart. And as you keep your elbows bent and pulling it apart, start to feel that opening into your chest. You're closer to the blocks, a little bit more ahead of you. Inhale here. And as you exhale, you start to sit back into like that invisible chair. You're pulling it apart, elbows slightly bent, pulling it apart. Sit back into your invisible chair like you had airplane wings. And then as you exhale, release the strap to the side. Take your hands to the blocks. Inhale, find a nice flat back. And as you exhale, soften and allow one knee and then the other to drop down. Let your hips come down to the earth and finding your blanket under your sit bones. And the reason we put the blanket is that it gives you a little bit more of that little tilt forward so you're not kind of hunching back and it finds you a little bit more lift. So sometimes just one blanket is not enough, sometimes two if your knees feel too high. So the more you bring weight under, the more the tendency of those knees to drop. So I'm gonna take a strap here. I'm gonna roll the shoulders up and back. So actually, let's take the strap over to that. The right side. Inhale, let your arms come up to the sky. And as you exhale, once again, finding your twist. And as you inhale, you lengthen your spine. As you exhale, perhaps you revolve your shoulders a little further back. Nice. And as you come out of this, we're going to come into a little bit more of a twist. We're going to take that left hand out and then turn your left thumb down, internally rotating that arm. You start to bring it behind your back. And now from here, if you can take your right hand, you start to guide that elbow up and over. And now you take the strap with your right hand and let it drop over your head behind. So the tendency here is the elbow to go to the side, but you want to try to see if it can sneak behind you and maybe walk your hands so close that they can find a little closer onto that strap. Some of you might even have the fingers attached, that's fine, or well, at least locking or close by. So you're coming into your Gomukhasana, cow face arms here. Take a nice deep breath in. As you exhale, perhaps you start to hinge forward. And you're also gonna start to feel a little bit more in your hips with that hinging. You can stop at any point. The full pose, I'm just going to show it to you. Not that doesn't mean that everybody can do that. It's just stacking one knee on top of the other. As you exhale, release. And as you release, let it go. Turn yourself again over to the left. And as you exhale, extending that left leg, see if you can let your hands come slightly next to you. Your right knee opens to the right. Now, if this feels too much, you can also put a block under it. And maybe find that strap to open the heart. Elbows are bent and so you can release the shoulders down the back. It's not about trying to grab the foot, but more like lifting of the heart. And as you exhale, release it out. And give your legs a little bit of a shake. Let's try it on the other side. So it's the other shin that's in front, so the right. And you twist over to the right. And you come out of it and you take your right hand out, internally rotating that shoulder. Take the back of that hand behind your back. And maybe you even take the elbow and start to slide it a little closer in. And you take the strap here and let it drop from the top so the bottom arm catches it. You might walk it a little closer in so the elbows come a little closer in. Find a lift and perhaps even hinge forward. Now again, this might be a lot. And if you have the flexibility of stacking those knees one on top of the other, finding the full Gomukhasana, cow face pose, you can go into it. And you release, let it go. Give it a little bit more that twist. And when you feel ready, you're gonna extend that leg forward and allow your body to fold. And again, this knee might feel different. So maybe this one you need to put a extra support under the knee because it doesn't like to be dropped. Just like you did before, you don't have to find the foot, but if you can find maybe the strap and the bending of the elbow so the shoulders relax a little bit more and the heart moves forward. And think about the back of the neck and the line with the spine, which is part of your spine, right? It's just continuation here. So nice and long. And as you exhale, release and let it go. Give your legs a little bit of a shake and moving it around as we start to find our way back onto the mat. If you like to have any props for your Shavasana, you might want to come by. I'm just going to take that round bolster or a blanket under the knee so I know that that's where I'm going to end up with my legs extended for Shavasana. And you can take your block here with you. So when you lay back, give your knees once again a hug and a gentle rock. Let the knees drop to one side once again. Soften the head, the gaze to the opposite side, noticing the extension through the side body. Maybe this time the arms can reach even more. As you exhale, soften and let the head, knees drop to the opposite side. When you come to the center, your feet drop down to the floor and taking that block under your sit bones. Find your Vipaditakada under your waterfall pose. And a big sigh as you start to soften your ankles, toes, and find a way that this feels restful. So if the legs are just stacked, there's no effort here. And if it feels like it's too much, if you prefer to have your legs up against the wall or over a couch or a chair, you can always move into it. And just feeling that reverse of the flow down your legs to the pool of your belly. Blowing to your heart. Exhale, that's cool and calming sensation. And from here, allowing those knees to slowly come into the chest. Press into your feet and bridge your hips up so you can take that block out of the way. And the knees come in once again. Again, you can hold behind your knees for your happy baby. Hold onto the shins or even the blades of the feet, whatever works for you. But try to keep your shoulders on the floor, hips on the floor, so you're relaxing. And then letting those legs extend over your bolster. If you want to have a blanket over your body for weight and warmth, or even covering your eyes with the eye pillow, this is a time to let go. No control the body, no control the breath. The body soften and release. eyes get heavy in the sockets once again. The tongue is floating in your mouth, soft, dry. The shoulders are relaxing, elbows and fingertips. Spine is fully supported. You feel that body relaxing, the belly soft, the hips heavy. And you continue to soften through the legs, ankles and toes. Happy where you are, you want to stay longer, please do. But if you feel like moving, start to wiggle the fingers and the toes, the wrists and the ankles. Take your time. Take a nice deep breath in. And give it back with a smile. Wiggle the fingers. Give the knees a hug. And as you roll over to the left, use your hands to come up to your seat. Take all the time that you need. You find the spine nice and tall. Head resting over the heart, and heart resting over the hips. Everything is stacked up nicely. And you feel ready to bring your palms together into Anjali Mudra in front of your heart. I'm going to finish with Padma Mudra, the Lotus Mudra. I'm going to keep your pinky fingers and your thumbs together and just open the other fingers like the petals of a flower. And like the lotus flower that comes from the mud and raises up into beauty and resilience, strong. With all the qualities of the heart blooming, finding yourself in inner peace, let your thumbs rise up to your forehead. And together we bow, namaste. The light in me bows to the light in you. Thank you so much for joining me. If you have any questions, doubts, please let me know. Otherwise, I'll see you around. Be well.